lampor vi har och vi kommer att använda det för alltså alla spotlight och utställningslampor vi har på gallerien, och vi har typ 50 styck där uppe, de kommer att användas här. Så det kommer att vara Anna.
Ja, hej! Hej allihopa, jag är fortfarande sjuk, jag har varit sjuk i en vecka. Jag vill bara säga, jag har lyssnat nu hela tiden så där, och jag, det som jag blir beklämd av faktiskt på riktigt, det är att jag tänker så här att det är ju skolan måste ju vilja att vi ska göra liksom en så professionell och så, ja vad ska man säga, bra utställningssituation som möjligt. Och om man då har prioriterat bort att vara i en extern lokal där det är någon annan som står för att hålla den nivån. Och när vi pratade om det här med rektorn innan hon, det var ju dagen innan hon lämnade, då så sa vi det som jättetydligt liksom anspråk, att så här, men om ni väljer att göra det på det här sättet, då måste den approach som vi har till den lokal vi är i, den måste vara liksom att skolan också vill att det ska se proffsigt ut och liksom se till att det finns bra belysning och att vi shapear upp det som ska vara. Och det är möjligt att man behöver göra val som man gör nu, men det som känns konstigt för mig, och där får ni rätta mig om jag har fel, det är att det känns som att skolan liksom tycker att det är upp till oss jättemycket. Alltså vi som grupp eller vi som årskurs.
Så. Hi. Sometimes you get this. It gets stuck on the plate. Whoopsie daisy. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. Man. Okay. Yeah. So, like what we're dealing with here is it's the strongest forces of nature. This uses Hävstång's effect, as you can see by the like nothing can stand against it, not even gravity. And then we have suction, which is also very strong. And then the centrifugal force, torsion, rotational, blah blah blah. But these are the strongest forces in nature that doesn't really exist. But in combination, they create gravity. So that's the entire idea around this. So I shall now, but there will be complications, as you can see. So now I will try to practically remove these. I should have added the supports to this to the build plate, but now I simply have to try and pry with the Hävstång's effect. As you can see, it's fucking impossible. Ah! Unless you read a book! Think a little! Yeah! Some guts! Now I attach this to this here, like so, again. And print the rest of the goddamn material. As so. Overcoming gravity is easy. Here we go. I'm bored. On my way again to fetch more resin. You see, when you add suspensoids to any given plastic, you by default, like, you create new elements of the periodic table. Somebody asked me, what does the Grief Mark 3 Beta consist of? What is it made out of? And I realized I had no idea, because these are entirely new elements. Or what Bob Lazar once called, famously, element 115. Element 115 naturally do not exist on this planet. It has to be created. So it's springtime, taking in the sun. Kom igen nu våren! Lys! Black absorbs light.
This is it. This is the magic moment. When the build plate is slowly hovering about the horizon, if you will, inside the machine, and you get to see if the build has stuck to the plate or not. More times it doesn't than it should, but when it does, then if it doesn't, I mean, just stop whatever you're doing, drop it, stop it, confirm, recalibrate, clean the entire goddamn tank, and readjust, calibrate, readjust, insert, then pour in more goddamn liquid, and then maybe re-slice in the software. But when it does stick, when you have done everything right, we're just about to find out, then it feels great. You put yourself into this. Why am I doing this? So, we're about to find out. In real time, I'm just gonna let it roll. This is my life now. Like watching paint dry, but worse. Yeah, so what are we looking for? At the horizon, where it gently hovers, we want to see black, because that means all the supports have stuck to the goddamn build plate! But if there is a silver fine lining, then you know nothing has stuck and you have to redo the process all over again by yourself. Let's watch. Please, God, don't let there be a fine silver lining on the horizon. It has to be black for it to work. This is my life now. this is I read it's gonna be a 9-hour print, just so you get it. All I need right now in the process is to not see a fine silver lining on the build plate as it rises, because then I will need to rethink, I guess. What time is it? It's 2 o'clock at night. Is it worth it? I really have no better place to go. I have nothing better on my hands right now to do than to speak to ghosts and look for tar. Not yet. Not yet. These are my lucky socks. I got them from my girlfriend. They comfort me. You can see there are little notes of threes here in B flat. What we are searching for is B flat. That's the key upon which this machine rises above the horizon. I have it set to bottom lift resin speed in the slicer to I use Shiri box. I'm not sure I pronounced that correctly, but I have it set to 8 versus 30 seconds. Yeah, so it's slow! You might think, can't I just go have a look? Like inside, meanwhile, to see if it's... No! You have to wait for it. The best part of my job is when I wait for the for it to rise above the horizon, and I gently go into slumber. And I wake up 6 hours later and it's all blank. We're not talking silver lining here, we're talking nothing stuck. Then I just have to rise up and do it all over again. Almost there. I am not putting you through this so that, like in a lame attempt to make you feel how I feel, because you can't feel how I feel, because that's impossible in a relative existence. But I want to at least give you an idea of how exciting this is. you might think, did I see black or did I see a silver lining? Not yet! Can you even see it from there? Like, it goes... self-destruct. Wait for it. There. Now I know, just by seeing as it rises, nothing but tar black, more tar black. That means the supports have stuck to the build plate. So now it's only 7 hours left of this particular print. And I have nothing to do. Nothing else to pursue. And I can't nod off. I would love some sleep, but I haven't slept in 3 months. 3 months. I would love to nod off, but I'm not allowed to. We're not allowed to.